is my pleasure to announce that our technology is available for the next process, which is the presidential nomination vote of the Green Party of the United States. Please take your seats. Asa Gordon, brother, please sit down. I'm looking around.
We are almost entirely on schedule. Let's keep it that way.
The aisle must be cleared. Sister, sister in the middle of the aisle, please sit down. Thank you. The brother with the from Texas, please sit down from the middle of the aisle. Take
That's
your conversation
you,
outside. I know that you can hear me. Please stop ignoring me and take it outside if you need
Denise,
the conversation.
Farheen,
we need
sit.
The seat. We need the aisle open, my friend. You're still in the aisle. Please. Really? Really, Tim McKee, pat them on the head. Thank you.
Sit.
I want to introduce.
Okay, just a few details that we need to go over before we get this section started. One is the count is going to be announced on the laptop over here. Two, we want the states when you announce your results, please hold up your state signs. Also, when you come out to report, come out to this middle aisle. There is a microphone here. Hillary has that. And please talk into the microphone. So now, the folks who are going to walk us through this next section are Holly Hart and Colin Bevan.
Holly, Colin.
Well, so this is finally what we're here for, right?
Woo-hoo!
We're finally at the final stage, the conclusion of what is actually the first step of what we know will be a groundbreaking, innovative, unique presidential adventure. It will spread our key values throughout the country. It'll help state parties grow, give a boost to local and statewide candidates, and grow the Green Party. This process began about a year ago at the national meeting in Alfred, New York, where delegates there discussed whether we wanted to run and the benefits of running a campaign, what kind of a campaign we wanted, what kind of a candidate, and how it could benefit and grow the Green Party. We'll learn more about that tomorrow. Safe to say, there was no question that we were going to run, and we will continue to run. During the past year, state parties and groups of Greens in keeping with our commitment to decentralization, grassroots, democracy, and accountability, got together across the country. They met, deliberated, participated, voted to support their choice of candidate for President of the United States. We've had participants from Green parties like the state of California, a state-established party with a ballot line recognized by the state and numbers of office holders, a state-run primary, to, for the first time ever, a group of people who came together to organize on Pine Ridge in South Dakota. And we allow pursuant to the election laws of their respective states, although they are respected too, and their party's rules for their delegations and choosing their delegations to the convention and establishing their preferences for a choice of candidate. Or if they're not an established party or an organized party, they have to call for a state convention and go through several motions to do that. And then all states must provide a ballot line for the Green candidate or work to find a Green ballot line. What we're going to do here is quickly go through the rules and explain what will be happening. And as they've mentioned, you're going to see the tally of votes over there. We're going to ask you to make sure to, when Hillary comes around with the microphone, to make sure to lean into her, to kind of go to the center if you can. And want to particularly thank David McCorkadale on the Credentials Committee for coming up with a handy list. For giving us the critical information we need to know about who to call. So what happens, each state called upon, oh, by the way, raise your sign too when you're called upon. Each state may cast a proxy vote of not more than one absent credential delegate, the total not to exceed the total allocation of delegates for that state. This will go in alphabetical order, Each state may either call its votes when called upon. You don't have to include all of your votes if you don't, but you may not vote only a portion and then come back later. You've got to either vote them all or not. You may pass to be called upon a second time. You may not pass twice. So keep that in mind. What's going to happen is when your state is called, your state reporter, one individual, will announce the number of delegates and proxies voting, the vote of your delegation. You have 2 minutes to make your statement about how wonderful your state is and your support. 2 minutes, and he's lived a rugged lifestyle and can take you down if you go over. He'll do it. It's not pretty. Also, in accordance with the media committee's wishes, please be nice about your state. And say something nice about what the Green Party is doing or something good that happened in your state, because we know that happens. So the way this works is it takes a simple majority, 50% threshold, to win. In the first round, some rules just be aware of. The no nominee and none of the above options remain options in all rounds of voting. If we go to a second, third, fourth, fifth round, they're going to stay there. You must vote, delegates must vote the way they've been instructed by their state party in the first round, the same for the second round, if there is one. Half votes are counted in the first round only, pursuant to our software rules. After the first round, if there is a winner, the candidate must formally accept the nomination. Otherwise, they're eliminated and we go to the second round. After the second round, all candidates must have declared in writing their intention that they will accept the nomination, and they must agree to cooperate with each member state party to be placed on each available green ballot line or work toward getting one. If it goes to a second round, the threshold will be a whole number greater than a half of the no abstention votes. If you understood that, you probably understood the Electoral Caucus thing this morning. For vice presidential candidate, they must also declare in writing to the election administrators their intention to accept the nomination. And same as above, work to support green ballot lines and accept them. What will happen is the nominee or a speaker for the nominee will propose that person. Then we will call for a show of hands to show a simple majority or more, and that wins. And that's it. And don't forget to bring your paperwork tonight at 8. So we're going to get started. Colin, why don't you read the first one?
And I think just to add that at a certain stage, it may become clear who's going to win the nomination, but we're going to ask you to hold your explosive enthusiasm until the last state has declared their votes. And so first of all, can we hear from the great state of Arkansas?
The great green state of Arkansas is very, very happy to be here and see you all today. Wanted to tell you just briefly that the Green Party is alive and kicking in Arkansas. We just recently completed our fourth successful ballot access drive. Don't know how we did that, but we did it. So we have full rights again in Arkansas. We also nominated a record number of candidates for the Green Party this year in Arkansas. 16 candidates will appear on the ballot. In addition to that, we have a Green Party candidate for the first time in each of the four congressional districts. We wanted that before, but we've achieved that now. And one of those district races is very interesting. Some of you may have heard of or know about Rebecca Kennedy. She's a great Green candidate in Arkansas. She's running for Congress in the 3rd congressional district. And last week, a very interesting thing happened. The Democratic candidate in that race self-destructed. And so there's no spoiler issue in that race. And we're looking forward to having a lot of fun with that. And so just want to let you know we're alive and kicking. We're fighting hard in Arkansas. And Arkansas has 3 delegates present. And each is voting a proxy. And all of us are casting our votes for Jill Stein.
Thank you.
Next up, the great state of Arizona.
Good afternoon, buenas tardes. Arizona has 5 delegates, 3 delegates, and 2 proxies. Buenas tardes. My name is Angel Torres, state co-chair of the Arizona Green Party and delegate to the National Committee. Arizona, the Grand Canyon state, the 48th state in the Union, is celebrating its centennial, 100 years of history. And the Arizona Green Party, founded in May of 1990, this year achieving ballot status for the 5th time, is celebrating 22 years of history. On behalf of our 4,900 registered Greens, Arizona awards 1 delegate to Dr. Kent Mesplay and 4 delegates to Dr. Jill Stein.
And now we'll hear from the Black Caucus, please.
Thank you. The Black Caucus cast 2 votes for Roseanne Barr. Thank you.
California.
Awesome. Good afternoon. My name is Ali Shantz, and I serve as co-chair for the Green Party of California. Recently, the Green Party of California has seen a growing number of youth and students joining the Green Party. Thank you. And are ascending into leadership positions. Notably, Harrison Wills, who's with us today, as president of the Associated Students of Santa Monica College, led the revolt on his campus against the college's efforts to privatize their educational system. And He successfully halted those efforts. Half of all students that graduate from 4-year universities in California graduate with an average of $18,000 of debt. As Jill Stein says, we need to forgive student debt and establish tuition-free education within California and across the country so youth of all socioeconomic backgrounds have access to education. Thank you.
As a male-to-female transsexual, I am honored to be here today, represented in the Green Party of the United States, in the California delegation, in our ongoing struggle for social and economic justice for gay, lesbian, bisexual, and transgender people, for the right to marry who we love, for the right to have the families of our choice, for the right to use the bathroom that best accommodates the gender identity or the gender being presented and expressed, for our medical needs to be able to be met without ridicule and discrimination.
I'm sorry, if you wouldn't mind actually telling us your vote, because our time is up. Our 2 minutes is up.
Maxine Daniel from California, Alameda County. And on behalf of the more than 100,000 California Greens, I'd like to cast our vote, 56 delegates, in proportion to our primary election. We cast 6 votes for Dr. Kent Mesplay, 22 votes for Roseanne Barr, and 28 votes for Dr. Jill Stein.
If we could hear, please, from the state of Colorado.
State of Colorado has 7 votes. We're kind of smoky right now. We have 7,000 plus registered Greens in Colorado, but we got 37,500 votes in the senatorial election in 2010, which was 2.4%. And we have 2 new chapters that have just gotten started in the last year. One in El Paso County and one in Douglas County. So our 7 votes are cast from our operation of our convention in May. We cast 1 vote for Dr. Ken Mesplay, 1 vote for Roseanne Barr, and 5 votes for the next president of the United States, Jill Stein.
Next state over from here, Connecticut.
Hi, my name is Tim McKee, one of the longtime getting old and gray Green Party members. I would like to introduce our Senate candidate, Jeff Russell, running for Senate. The Green Party of Connecticut has 27 appointed or elected office holders in our state. In a fusion election in the 80s, we ran a Green and Democratic candidate in some of the first elections for Greens. So we are proud to say one candidate came to our state early and often to campaign. And we still support all the other candidates out there. We have four delegates present, four proxies. We are proud to cast and know that our next candidate is fine. We cast 8 votes for Dr. Jill Stein.
The District of Columbia, please.
The DC Statehood Green Party, which is the only supported by the Green Party as a state, has 4 delegates. Free for Jill and 1 for Roseanne. Proxy, 3 delegates and 1 proxy. I am proud to say that on February 2nd, 2012, on the 120th anniversary of the adoption of the second section of the 14th Amendment penalty to democratize the Electoral College, we issued a proclamation. A proclamation of the DC Statehood Green Party to democratize the Electoral College, to redress national state initiatives to institutionalize minority vote dilution, whether racial, economic, political, or by third party affiliations by the enactment of voter ID laws and winner take all politics. We are proud that a majority of Greens on the platform may not have known that they supported this proclamation. Unfortunately, too many Greens, and I say probably because you were in ignorance of that, you supported the National Popular Vote Initiative over this, which relies on endorsing Bush versus Gore ruling that you don't have a constitutional right to vote.
30 seconds.
Give me my 30 seconds.
Of course.
Which relies on versus McPherson, which taught in our law schools, overturned Reconstruction and established white supremacy in the South. That is now on your platform, unfortunately. We will resurrect your intelligence on this matter, and we know you will correct it.
Thank you. Did you guys get the vote?
And yes, my geography was bad, but I do know that the next state is not next door to here. Florida.
Delaware.
Mr. McCorkadale of Delaware did not have his state on here. Delaware is okay. Delaware, we'll put him on.
Yeah, Delaware is okay.
Delaware.
Delaware, here I am. The first state and the second smallest state. And the state that has given you some of the worst banking regulations in the country. I apologize for that. I tried like hell to stop it. But one man is no army against those guys. We know who we're talking about. But I'm very, very glad to have been involved in the last 9 months. Delaware has the only occupation that has not been evicted. We are 9 months with tents. And we were there, believe it or not, allowed to, by the Chancery Court of Delaware, which just befuddles me. So anyway, Delaware has 4 votes. They're going to Dr. Jill Stein. And
thank
I
you.
Need a little help with this one. Mic check!
Mic check!
Come on, mic check!
Mic check!
We are!
The 99%!
Banks got bailed out!
We
you.
And now the state of Florida, please.
Hello, yeah, wow, what an introduction. Okay, now as co-chairs of the state of Florida, we say we need to redistribute our priorities. And we are soon to be the even greater state when we become a state with the first Green Party state legislator, Karen Morian. Stand up. Okay, and Greens, we already have a couple other Greens running in the state, and we do have in Tampa an elected official. Okay, we have 7 delegates, 1 proxy, and we one for Kent Mesplay. We cast 2 for Roseanne Barr, and 5 for Jill Stein.
Next up, and I'm sure this one is right, Georgia.
Hey, y'all. I'm here to say that from the state, wonderful state of Georgia, the home of Martin Luther King Jr., a man of nonviolence and peace, we're glad to be here. I'm representing a lot of other folks that couldn't be here because they're very busy working on a campaign for Kwabena Nkomo. If you check our website and give us any help, we'd love it. We also wanted to point out that in 2004, we did have a full slate of candidates. We are working tirelessly to make that happen again. And I want to recognize a special Georgian who now has moved to Tennessee. Nan Garrett is in Georgia helping us tirelessly. Thank you, Nan. And so from the great state of Georgia, a place where people with a spirit of democracy and self and social justice will prevail, we give our 2 votes to Roseanne Barr.
And all the way from Hawaii.
Aloha. The greetings from the independent sovereign nation of Hawaii. Currently occupied as the 50th state of the United States. We also look forward to the day, this is my 4th out of 5 presidential nominating conventions. And it's nice to be here, and I'm waiting for the time when we have our convention in Hawaii. So from Santa Fe to Los Angeles, to Denver, to Chicago. I missed the 04. Milwaukee. No, I missed it. I wasn't there. And then to 2012 here in Baltimore. And as a young person, I lived in Maryland outside of Washington, D.C. We're also the state that presented this nation and this party with the first partisan victory of the Green Party against the Democrat and Republican 1992 Keiko Bank, who this year is coming back to electoral politics and running for the against the current Speaker of the House in Hawaii. She's challenging him in Oahu, the 20th district.
30 seconds, please.
Okie dokie. Aloha to everybody. Hawaii would like to give 2 votes. We have 2 delegates and 2 proxies. We'd like to give 2 votes to the favorite daughter, Roseanne Barr. And we'd like to give our other 2 votes to Jill Stein. Aloha.
I can't help this. I'm anal retentive, but somebody with a Roseanne sign keeps holding it up upside down. You might want to turn it right side up.
Next up, Illinois.
Hello, my name is Samantha Rachnowski. I am a former Western Illinois University campus Greens member. This is our president. I am on the Illinois Women's Caucus that is newly formed. I was the petitioning coordinator for the petitioning drive. I am a National Committee delegate, and I am also a member of the National Women's Caucus and National Now Forming Youth Caucus. From the land of Lincoln, as you all know, Lincoln was the most successful third-party candidate ever. We are also home to the first black president ever. And though you are not applauding him because he has not lived up to our expectations, it is still incredibly important that he was a man of color that was elected. And we are also a state that is proud to announce that we have achieved ballot access for the Green Party of the United States by turning in over 29,000 petitions. And we are proud to cast our delegates. We have 14 delegates and 5 proxies. We have 12 votes for Jill Stein. We have 4 votes for Roseanne Barr, 1 for Kent Mesplate, and 2 non-committed votes. Thank you.
If we could hear from Indiana, please.
Hello there, I'm Andrew Straw, and I am the delegate from Indiana. And thanks. I'm also the congressional candidate in District 2, which is in the South Bend area. Indiana has a lot of work to do. We got right to work this year, last year. It's ongoing. Mitch Daniels, thanks a lot. We also have an ongoing problem with hog farms, and I'm fighting that as an attorney in Indiana, so factory hog farms, which is kind of symbolic of our situation with ballot access. We got 30,000 signatures to get on the ballot in 2006 for our Secretary of State, and guess what? Wasn't enough. Obama, in the second district, my district, they forged signatures to get him on the ballot. So it seems a little unfair that we would fall a little short, like McCain also in Indiana fell short in 2008, but it was a technicality, and they let them both on. So, well, right. Indiana is very proud to support Jill Stein. She came to South Bend in March, and she was on TV and just did a great job representing our positions, our party, and we're proud to give our one vote to Jill.
And next we hear from...
You get 2 votes because you can count your proxy, is what I'm being told.
Indiana?
You get to represent your delegate that's not here. 2 for Jill.
Next is Iowa.
Hi, I'm Wendy Barth from Iowa, a state where you can marry who you love. Thank you. And I just wanted to give you all this idea that I thought was profound. Unrestricted growth is the ideology of a cancer cell. Might be useful. Iowa gets 4 votes this year. We're casting 2 votes for Roseanne Barr and 2 votes for Jill Stein. Thank you.
Thank you. Kentucky.
Kentucky, over here. Whew. Just keeping me on my toes.
My name is Josh Robinson. I am the delegate from the Commonwealth of Kentucky. We have just gotten organized as a Green Party, and we are very happy. Thank you. We are happy to have joined the movement. We look forward to working with all of you in the future. We have 2 votes, 1 delegate, 1 proxy. which are split one for Roseanne Barr and one for the next president of the United States, Dr. Jill Stein.
Louisiana, Maine.
Up next is a Lavender Caucus.
Hello, I'm A.J. Signeri, a representative for the Lavender Caucus, a caucus made up of activists and organizers that are out front on the issues of LGBT issues, and we are going to cast our two votes to Dr. Jill Stein.
From the state of Maine, please.
Hi, my name is Asher Platts. I'm an occupier who, since occupying Wall Street and Freedom Plaza in DC, is now running for state senate in the state of Maine. I also, since then, have become chair of the Maine Green Party. The great state of Maine, where the first state Green Party was founded in 1984 under a maple tree in Augusta, where Greens got instant runoff voting into the city charter for the city of Portland, Maine. We cast our 13 delegates, oh wait, I got more stuff to brag about, where we've had continuous ballot access since 1998, and we also have the first LEED Gold airport in the United States thanks to our Green City Councilors. We cast our 13 delegates in a split caucus in proportion to our state convention, six for Barr and seven for the next president of the United States, Jill Stein.
Next, our gracious host, the charming Maryland.
Hello, everybody. Greetings from the Maryland Green Party, where we're continuously fighting for the life of our Chesapeake Bay, which is mostly dead zone these days, nothing can live. We're also continuously fighting for the life of our cities and for the civil rights of all of our residents here in the great state of Maryland. Unfortunately, we're also fighting to stay on the ballot here in Maryland. After 10 years of continuous ballot access, we are struggling to get back on the ballot. So all of you who are watching from home, if you're a Maryland registered Green, please, please go online and sign our petition. Help us get back on the ballot so we can provide a diversity of political opinions in the state. Go to, here's the website. Everybody be quiet so people at home can write down the website, right? It's bit.ly/mgp-petition-central. So again, that's bit.ly/mgp-petition-central. You can also find the petition by going to the Maryland Green Party website, which is mdgreens.org. I'd also like to announce that we have two candidates running for Congress this year, including Mr. George Gluck, who's here with us today. He's going to be... George Gluck is going to be running in the 8th Congressional District here in Maryland. We also have Bob Auerbach, who I'm not sure if... Bob's here in the audience also, Mr. Bob Auerbach, who's going to be running for Congress in the 5th Congressional District. So please help us get on the ballot so we can, you know, continue to provide a diversity of political voices here in Maryland. The Maryland Green Party delegation, we proudly cast our votes for two strong Green women. We have six delegates. One vote going to Roseanne Barr, and five votes going to Jill Stein.
I'm going to run to Massachusetts and run back.
The home state of Dr. Jill Stein, Massachusetts.
Yeah. Hi, my name is Joyce Palmer Fortune, and the great state of Massachusetts would like to pass at this time.
You may do so.
So next up, Michigan.
Hey.
Suspense.
Hi, I'm Priscilla Jubeck. I'm from the great state of Michigan, also known as the Great Lakes State. I'm a proud member of the Detroit Greens. Our Green Party of Michigan has maintained Green Party ballot access since the year 2000. We're excited to be here at this historic moment, and we have 10 delegates and are carrying six proxy votes. The state of Michigan would like to cast two votes for our current Senate candidate, Harley Mickelson. Woo! Two votes for Ken Mesplay. Three votes for Roseanne Barr. And nine votes for Jill Stein.
The state of Minnesota, please.
Hi, my name is Amber Garland. Greetings from the great state of Minnesota, home of the Twin Cities of Minneapolis and St. Paul, where the founding members of the Green Party of the United States first came together to draft our 10 key values. The state of Minnesota has seven delegates. We cast four votes for Dr. Jill Stein and three votes for Roseanne Barr.
Next, Mississippi.
Hello, my name is Nikita Gandy, and we're from the great state of Mississippi. Thank you. The Magnolia State, a home of such civil rights luminaries as Fannie Lou Hamer and Medgar Evers, which still bears the strange fruit in the form of six executions and limits on the right to vote, but fortunately rejected the personhood amendment. And, and also we are the home of the authors of the Green Song, Evan Peacock and Jan Hilligus, right there. We have two delegates, two proxies, and we cast all four of our votes for Jill Stein.
Thank you. Next, it's New Jersey.
National Women's Caucus?
They're at the end.
You're in the W's, not the N's. Sorry.
No, we're the National Women's Caucus. We're up there in the N's. We were a while ago.
The National Women's Caucus.
We don't care. That's fine. Yeah.
Okay, the National Women's Caucus.
That's right.
The National Women's Caucus is proud that our race for the nomination in 2012 again gave us strong green women who demonstrated the spirit of cooperative competition. As a great example is why Green Party politics and policies are better than business as usual, slash and burn, winner take all contest. To our great sister, Roseanne Barr, who brought us new contacts in Pine Ridge, in the gay communities, in the Dakotas, who brought us our first endorsement from the National Organization for Reform of Marijuana Laws, who brought us this beautiful, plain-speaking honesty and humor. We thank you and we honor you by casting one vote for Roseanne Barr. To our sister, Jill Stein, who brought us new and renewed ballot lines, who showed us a great example of team building, who has qualified for federal matching funds. And who earned our nomination by working it. We thank you and we honor you by casting one vote for Dr. Jill Stein.
And now, New Jersey, please.
Greetings from the proud state of New Jersey. My name is Bill Ryder, and I serve as chair of the Green Party of New Jersey, and I'm proud to be here with my fellow representatives today. And I'd like to start off by honoring Woody Guthrie, this is his 100th anniversary this weekend, and he traveled across America many times, and he was a fighter for the poor and a fighter for workers. Let me hear everybody say, this land is your land. New Jersey is called the Garden State, but we're not satisfied with that. It's a beautiful name, but we'd rather it be called the Green State. And someday soon, we want to see green states popping up on that red and blue map. We want New Jersey to be the first green state to pop on, or any of our states here today. And soon, someday, maybe the whole map will be green. New Jersey is one of 17 states to approve and authorize medical marijuana. And we have with us today our future senator from New Jersey, who is a fighter for medical marijuana and is the one of the directors of the American Cannabis Nurses Association, Ken Walsky. Stand up, Ken. New Jersey is one of the states that ended the death penalty. And now we want to end LWOP, life without parole, is just as bad. We want New Jersey to be known as a single-payer state. We have five votes. We're casting one for Roseanne Barr and four for a doctor that visited our convention in March and the next president of the United States, Jill Stein.
And now from my home state, the state I hope to represent in the United States House of Representatives, New York.
Hello, I'm Ursula Rosam. I'm proud to report from the beautiful state of New York, where we have 13 delegates and three proxies. New York State was the birthplace of Occupy Wall Street. We're holding the line against hydrofracking. We're the state where in 2004, Green Mayor Jason West performed 25 same-sex marriages as an act of civil disobedience 7 years before marriage equality passed in our state. A state that is ground zero for civil resistance to the US drone wars. A state where Woody Guthrie wrote, "This land is your land," in 1940. A state where our governor, Andrew Cuomo, received more money from the Koch brothers than Wisconsin's Scott Walker. The adopted home of Harriet Tubman, the land of the Iroquois Confederacy, whose strong women inspired the women's empowerment movement. New York State, where lifelong civil rights activist Colia Clark is running for US Senate. And where I'm proud to be running as a representative to the U.S. House of Representatives. New York cast 2 delegate votes for Roseanne Barr and 14 for Jill Stein.
Next up is North Carolina.
Turner from North Carolina, Green Party of North Carolina.
One moment, there's a mic issue here. Not a mic check, but another.
Is it working?
Check. That's better.
Thank you. Yes? Again, I'm Wayne Turner from the Green Party of North Carolina. The Green Party of North Carolina, or the delegation of North Carolina, is proud to represent our state at this historic event. Despite the repeated attempts of the Democratic Party, they have not been able to extinguish us in North Carolina. We're still alive and kicking down there. Recently, the Democrats lost the legislature in North Carolina to the Republicans, who, to our surprise, proceeded to address global warming. Unfortunately, they addressed it by passing a law saying that the level of the sea cannot rise faster than is prescribed by the state legislature. I could go on in that vein, but I will not. In order to begin to undo this nonsense, the delegation in North Carolina, 4 delegates, cast 1/2 of 1 vote for Kent Mesplay, 1 vote for Roseanne Barr, and 2 1/2 votes for the next president of the United States, Jill Stein.
The state of Ohio, please.
I'm Connie Goodall Newton from the state of Ohio. So we fought hard for ballot access and won it in 2010 when the ballot access law was declared unconstitutional. And being an official party in Ohio has given us standing to do election protection activities so we can fight for the right to vote for African Americans, students, and other disenfranchised voters. In Ohio, we're fighting against fracking, and we also defeated the anti-worker legislation, Senate Bill 5. Okay. By the rules of our convention, we do proportional voting, and we have six delegates, three proxies. Jill Stein got 90% of our votes, so we'll be casting our 9 votes for Jill Stein. And I'd like to thank all of the candidates who've run for president for making this a vibrant party and convention. Thank you.
The next state up is Oregon.
Sorry, I'm from Pennsylvania, I'm jumping the gun. Oregon.
Well, Oregon is next on the list.
Yes.
It's Pennsylvania. It's also next in the alphabet. They told us that this morning. Yeah, that's true, that's true. Well, it's either Oregon or Pennsylvania.
Oregon,
okay, thank you.
From the Beaver State, the Pacific Green Party of Oregon represents sustainability, social and economic justice, grassroots democracy, and peace and nonviolence, fighting LNG terminals, fighting against the drug war by legalizing marijuana, up for vote in November, the Oregon Cannabis Tax Act, fighting to save our public forests from clear-cutting, fighting for single-payer health care, feed-in tariff renewable energy, ranked voting and proportional representation, which Oregon voters passed in 1908, yet to be re-implemented, and lastly, but not completely, fighting to enforce comprehensive campaign finance reform passed in 2006 by Oregon voters that Democrats have refused to enforce. One of the birth states of the Green Party in the United States of America, our bicycle infrastructure is the best in the nation with 7% of trips by bicycle in Portland. Where I, Seth Woolley, am running for Secretary of State with Pat Driscoll for Treasurer and a slate of Green Peace candidates for Congress. Oregon, of the great Cascadian bioregion, has 4 present delegates, 4 proxies. We, the Pacific Green Party of Oregon, cast 4 votes for Dr. Jill Stein, and
4 votes for Roseanne Barr. We actually passed it with IRV 4-5, but we lost a delegate, so we cannot cast that vote.
Now the state of Pennsylvania, please.
Hello, everyone. My name is Steve Baker from the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, the home of the Liberty Bell and the Constitution, and the next Vice President of the United States, Sherry Hankala. We are a very abused state. We have not had ballot access for many years, and we are tired of it. But we struggle on, and we are in a ballot access struggle presently. I will be here tomorrow morning at 9 to talk about help. We need help in Pennsylvania. We have 2 weeks left to collect about 20,000 signatures. So whether we make it or not, the party in Pennsylvania is strong, and we will continue on. I would like to pass it on to David O, who will tell you how our caucus results came out.
Thank you. I'm Dave. I'm from beautiful Bucks County in Pennsylvania. I am proud to let everybody know that in Pennsylvania, through the way we voted, the local caucuses, we split our votes in a very, very marginal split of 4-3 in favor of Jill Stein. And the 3 votes were for Roseanne Barr.
The next state is Rhode Island.
Buenas tardes, amigos y amigas, compañeras y compañeros.
I am Tony Afina. I am the chair-elect of the Green Party of Rhode Island, the Ocean State. The Green Party of Rhode Island is the fifth oldest Green Party in the United States, and we are in the Ocean State of Rhode Island, which was the first state to declare its independence from Great Britain in 1772, when my forebears set fire to the tax-collecting British ship, the Gaspé, in Narragansett Bay. We were then the last state to ratify the Constitution, holding out until the Bill of Rights had been approved. We were the first state, we were the initial state of the Industrial Revolution in the Americas, with the first factory, and consequently, by definition, we are the birthplace of the industrial working class in the United States, and we are proud of it. We hope to be participants in the next great American revolution, the Green Revolution. The Green Party of Rhode Island was one of the original 12 Green Parties that formed the Association of State Green Parties. We were one of the original 26 parties that formed the Green Party of the United States. We have placed a Green candidate on the ballot for president in every election, 1996, 2000, 2004, 2008, and we will do it again in 2012.
30 seconds, please.
You might know that Rhode Island is the bluest of blue states. The 538 blog estimates a 100% probability that Mitt Romney will not win the state of Rhode Island. Of course, they think Barack Obama will. We'd like to think the Green candidate will win Rhode Island. We have, as a state, cast our four delegates' votes in this way. One vote for Roseanne Barr, and we appreciate her outreach to working-class Americans of all colors. We appreciate her contacts in communities of color, and we appreciate her appeal and her outreach to women in America. Our remaining three votes, we are pledged to award to Dr. Jill Stein, the next president of the United States. On August 18th and 19th, Jill will be in Rhode Island. Any of you who are in New England Northeast, please come and join us for a rally for jobs, peace, and planet at the Roger Williams National Memorial, where the National Park Service is gleefully helping us to host a rally in honor of Jill and the Green Party at a memorial which recognizes the separation of church and state. That's what that memorial is all about. On August 19th, we invite you all to North Scarborough Beach in Rhode Island, where we will all make a splash with Jill Stein. Come and join us in Rhode Island. Thank you very much.
The state of South Carolina, please.
My name is Larry Carter Center, and I am the candidate to oppose the nation's worst House Speaker, Bobby Harrell. Remember, www.hirelarryfirebobby.com. The state of South Carolina, the nation's leading exporter of automobiles. The state of South Carolina, the nation's repository of the most hazardous, toxic, slow cancer waste. The state of South Carolina, where it is ground zero for the war on women, where our pseudo-governor, our cyber-elected governor, just vetoed funding for rape victims' medical treatment.
They're a distraction.
She calls them a distraction. The state of South Carolina, where we were honorably led by the great candidate for United States Senate, Tom Clements, the Southeast Regional Director for the abolition of this deadly technology of nuke boiling of water to make electricity.
He got 10% of the vote.
He got 10% of the vote. South Carolina has three delegates present and three proxies. This Tuesday, there is a special election for the first woman, and only woman who could possibly serve in this state's Senate, Sue Edward, Everyone listening, in Senate District 41, vote Tuesday. On July 17, vote green. We cast one vote for the Honorable Roseanne Barr, and we cast five votes for the next President of the United States, Dr. Jill Stein.
The state of Tennessee.
And the great volunteer state of Tennessee, home of the King of Rock and Roll, and Memphis Blues, and Nashville Country, and Smoky Mountain Bluegrass, and also the home of the Highlander Center that empowered Rosa Parks to sit in the front of the bus. And we have a Green Party that sued the state of Tennessee for their unconstitutional ballot access laws and won in federal court. It was sent back to the state to revise those laws. They did not. We sued again and won again. This time, the state was chewed out by the judge up one side and down the other for not providing a case. So we are, but they appealed in any case to the Sixth Circuit Court, and later this month we will find out that we have got our ballot line because the state has no case, as I said. And we have 12 candidates this year. First time we've had such a large slate in Tennessee. We're very happy and proud about that. And for the working class hero, Roseanne Barr, the state of Tennessee cast 1 1/2 votes. And we cast 2 1/2 votes for the next president of the United States, Dr. Jill Stein.
Texas.
The state of Texas, please.
The state of Texas has 12 delegates in the House, all voting. And all living proof that not all of our progressives live in Austin. We'd like to announce to the world that after a wildly successful petition drive in 2010, wherein we got ballot access and one of our candidate for state controller, won more than 5% of the vote statewide. That assured us ballot access yet again in 2012. And we have taken great advantage of that by having nearly as many candidates for all levels of office, county, state, and federal, as the rest of the United States combined. And because the Democratic Party has not fielded candidates for some statewide offices, a pretty good chance at resuming that ballot access for 2014 and beyond. We would like to remind the rest of the nation that friends don't let friends vote straight Democrat. And furthermore, the Green Party of the Lone Star State of Texas would like to cast its votes as follows. 9 votes for Dr. Jill Stein of Massachusetts. 2 for the eminent Roseanne Barr of Hawaii. And 1 for Rhett Smith of Texas.
And next, the Commonwealth of Virginia.
Why? And now for something totally different.
Yeah.
Which way?
Which way they
vote? The Commonwealth of Virginia. Not just the home of the so-called National Governors Association. We are proud to be the home of a number of elected soil and water commissioners who educate residents throughout the state about the importance of soil and water conservation and our storm water. We are also proud to be the state with a number of appointed green office holders, including myself. I was appointed by an all-Democratic county board as chairman of the Tenant and Landlord Commission this year. I represent all 60% of the residents in Arlington County are tenants in rental properties. Also, our candidates this year, running for United States Congress, Joe Galdo, you stand up. For the 8th consecutive year, the local that I founded, the Arlington Green Party, has a candidate for local office. This year it is longtime Green Party activist and petition gatherer, Audrey Clement. Audrey Clement running for county board. The Commonwealth of Virginia will cast 0.5 vote for Kent Mesplay, 0.5 vote for Harley Mickelson, 0.5 vote for Roseanne Barr, and 3.5 votes for Dr. Jill Stein.
And now the state of Washington, please.
The state of Washington is known as the Evergreen State. Yes, it rains, not as much as you'd think, but we'd like you to think it does because we have too many people already, unless you're Greens, and then we'll let you move in. The state of Washington has, in Rainier Valley, in the southern part of Seattle, the most diverse area in the entire United States. We're very proud of that. We're also proud of the fact that if you've ever checked out the matching funds in Jill Stein's campaign, first is Massachusetts. She lives there, okay? Second is New York, big state. Third is California. And fourth is Washington. So we hope you feel a little bit guilty about that, and we'll open your wallets and checkbooks a little farther than you thought you would before. We want to announce that on the 17th of August, Jill Stein will be the featured speaker on Friday night at Hemp Fest, which is a three-day largest Hemp Fest in the entire United States. And we have four votes and four delegates here. We are casting all four votes for Jill Stein. Thank you.
We have just a couple more states left to report, and I'm informed that we're running behind. So what we're going to do is ask those couple states to really compress that, just say hello.
No, it's all right.
I know it's not fair, but...
It's all right.
The Women's Caucus ought to be glad that, and usually we were not last. But if you could be forbearing and just do that and let us have your votes, and then we can continue, because there is more to come after this, I'm informed. So next up is West Virginia.
Hi, everybody. Bruce Brenninger here. I am the vice chairman of the Mountain Party, which holds the ballot access for the Green Party, the National Green Party in West Virginia. And I have here with me Jesse Johnson, who ran for president 2008. West Virginia. Thank you. West Virginia is ground zero for mountaintop removal and corrupt politicians, and hydro fracking. I wanted to tell you that a lot of people saw the movie about running for the mountains, produced by these fine young ladies here, and Jesse about his work in the mountains in West Virginia, and we'll be showing that film again today at 5 o'clock right here in this theater. If you missed it, you can be happy to see that. Please come. And our great state of West Virginia casts its votes two for Kent Mesplay, one for Roseanne Barr, and one for Jill Stein.
Wisconsin, please.
An objection, okay.
I'll tell you what, why don't we go with, Wisconsin? Those guys make it snappy, and you guys figure out how you're going to cast your votes and come right back.
We will not make it snappy, but I will go.
All right.
I just want to say something. All the other states have sort of implied with their boasts, so I'll say it straight up. Wisconsin is the best state.
Yeah. All right.
But only in certain areas. Other states are better in certain areas too. And we're the best state because we have more Greens elected per capita at the local level. We have the longest serving Green. And we have the youngest elected Green, Leland Pan, who you guys saw earlier. I also want to quickly give a shout out to the Indecision Twitter feed, which has been doing terrific coverage of this event and is the only major media outlet here. So thank you for covering that. I'm sorry, C-SPAN, more people are signed up on their Twitter feed than watch your show. I just got to say it. I also want to say Wisconsin is the heart of the fight back against austerity in this country. We started the movement. The movement has grown much bigger than Wisconsin, but we are still fighting. And I want to thank everyone here for supporting Wisconsin through what we've been going through. Wisconsin was the home of Ask Me. It's the home of public unionism, fighting Bob La Follette, Social Security, and the Republican Party. We all have our flaws. But we are also the home of the campaign for Jill Stein for president, and very proud to say that. And with that, I want to announce we are casting one vote for Kent Mesplé, one vote for Roseanne Barr, and five votes for the next president of the United States, Dr. Jill Stein.
I have a delegate from West Virginia back to figure out the little issue. What was the concern? Has it been resolved? Dave? Colin? Holly?
I believe the objection was that not all the delegates were registered.
So can we repeat the objection so that we can resolve the West Virginia vote?
I was in a hurry to get in, and I'll more than happy to do that.
Can we accept Jesse as a delegate from the floor for their two delegates? Is that okay? All right, and then I think their previous count stands, and we can move on?
Yeah. We agree, right?
All right.
And now we return to the state of Massachusetts.
We, the people of the great Commonwealth of Massachusetts, the home of the original Tea Party revolt against the power of corporate monopolies, the home of Shays Rebellion, the first revolt against bank foreclosures, against farmers and veterans who were defrauded of their pensions. The home of Sojourner Truth, ex-slave, abolitionist, women's rights activist. The state where 10 years ago, the Greens merged with the Rainbow Coalition to form the Green Rainbow Party of Massachusetts. Massachusetts. First in the nation in marriage equality. Home of our favorite daughter, Dr. Jill Stein, and the next president of the United States, we cast one vote for Kent Mesplé, one vote for Harley Mickelson, and nine votes for Dr. Jill Stein.
Okay, of course. Our first round of voting is concluded, so as our rules say, if we have a more than 50% simple majority, we will have a winner. What does our tally say? We have a winner? We can't see that. So 193.5 for Jill Stein, and that is more than 50%. 193.5. Okay, the mic is not up.
Okay.
We have a simple majority, and Jill Stein is our next vice president. I'm anticipating because there's something to stay seated because there's more to come. But Jill Stein will be the next president of the United States of America.
go, we go. 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 Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. A quick reminder that that chant began when Ralph Nader heard "Go Ralph Go" and, to his credit, leaned into the microphone and said, "No, no, go we go. Go we go." And that's what's happening with this party. At this point,